What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, I'm doing a nice little mini series dealing with installing and configuring a two-tier PKI enterprise setup. PKI stands for public key infrastructure. This is part one of the mini series. It's all about installing and configuring an offline root, a CA server. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is create a CA policy.inf file on your root CA server before we do anything. So we're going to go into this learn.microsoft.com website. They actually provide you information. If you scroll down a little bit, they give you a nice little template that you are able to use. We're going to copy this information and we are going to head over into our root CA server. We are going to click on the start menu. We're going to locate Windows PowerShell, right click on it, go to more and run it as an administrator. Now, the first command that we are going to do will be the following, and we're going to hit enter. We're going to hit yes here, and we're going to paste our information. Now, before we save the CA policy, make sure you change the URL. Once you make that change within this file, we are going to exit out of it and we are going to save it. We're going to check on the CA policy and we are able to open up the File Explorer. We're going to go to the C drive. Let's go inside Windows and there goes our new CA policy file. Now it is time for us to install the Active Directory certificate services within your root CA server. Pretty simple. So we're going to click on start. We're going to locate and open up the server manager. On the upper right-hand side, let's click on Manage. Let's click on Add Roles and Features. It's going to load up the wizard. Let's click Next here, Next, Next. We're going to locate Active Directory Certificate Services, which should be the first one. We're going to give it a check mark. We're going to click Add Features to add all the features that we need. We're going to click Next here, Next, Next. For roles, this is what we want. Let's click Next. We're going to click Install. It's going to start installing, and once it's done, it's going to give you this. We're going to click on Configure Active Directory Certificate Services on the destination server. That is a hyperlink, so click on it. It's going to give you this. We're going to click on Next. For the services, we want to configure the certification authority one, so give it a check mark. Let's click Next here. It is going to be a standalone CA. The reason that the enterprise CA is grayed out is because this machine should not be part of your domain. Offline, not domain join, okay? Don't add this to your domain. Your root CA should not be added to your domain. Once you're done here, click Next. It is going to be a root CA. Click Next. We're going to create a new private key, so click Next. For the key length, let's click on the dropdown. Let's change it to 4096. Let's click Next here. I'm going to leave everything as the default. Click Next. Now, by default, it's 5 years. I've seen companies do 10 years, but for my lab, because the last video of this little mini series, I'm going to show you guys how to renew everything. But for my lab, I'm actually going to do 3 months because the last video on this mini series is me showing you guys how to renew it. So I'm going to do 3 months. Click Next here. Click Next here. A nice little confirmation, configure. And if everything works well, you should get a green check mark that the configuration has completed and has succeeded. Now it's time for us to configure our root CA extensions. Now to do that, within the server manager on the upper right-hand side, let's click on Tools. Let's locate Certification Authority. It's going to load this up. We're going to select our server. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to go into Properties. We're going to go inside extensions. Within extensions, we're going to keep the C drive. Everything else, we need to remove it. So let's select the first one, click on remove, click yes. Select the second one, remove it, click yes. Select the last one, remove it, hit yes. So the only one you should have is this. Now let's click on add, and we're going to add the following. Now this is the syntax. All we need to do is change the following. Make sure you change the URL to the full qualified domain name of your intermediate CA. We're going to select it, right click on it, copy it, go back here, let's paste it, click OK. From here, we're going to enable the following, include the CRLs and include in the CDP. Enable those two options and we are going to click apply. Now, once you click apply, do not hit yes. We don't want to restart the services, not yet, so click no. Now, once you do that, click on the drop-down menu where it says CRL, and we are going to pick authority information access. And from here, we need to remove a couple of things. We're only going to leave the C drive path. Everything else is going to be removed. So select the first one, click remove, hit yes. Select the second one, remove, hit yes. Select the last one, remove it, and hit yes. Now let's click on add. We're going to add the following. This is the syntax. Just make sure you add their server name, which would be the full qualified domain of your intermediate CA. So I'm going to select this, right click on it, and copy it. We're going to come over here, paste it, click OK. And the only thing that we're going to enable with this particular path would be include in the AIA extension of issue certificates. Let's give it a check mark. We're going to apply it and now hit yes, and then we're good to go. Now it's time for us to export our root CA certificate. So let's head inside the general tab. Let's click on view certificate. Let's go to details and let's click on copy to file. You're going to get a certificate export wizard dialog box. So let's click on next. We're going to leave it as a DER format. Click next here. Click on browse, and I'm going to drop it into the following path. Windows System 32, cert SRV, cert enroll. Provide a name. This is the name that I'm going to provide my certificate. Click on save. Click on next. Click on finish. Export was successful. Click OK here. Click OK. Click OK. And that's it, guys. That is how we configure our root CA. Stay tuned for part two, which we are going to configure our intermediate CA. So hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.